Investigators say the deadly events were set into motion by a power outage on Wednesday morning.
This is a fluke thing that happened to these people, and it's a tragedy. You know, it's real a tragedy. But somewhere along the line, we had to figure out what happened in that home.
When authorities discovered the bodies of 34-year-old Megan Keller, a highly respected supervisor with the Worcester Police Department, and her 29-year-old husband Cody Keller inside their home, the investigation immediately focused on a coal burner in the basement. Then, as firefighters began removing hot coals from the burner, the chief investigator for the Richland County Coroner's Office was standing outside the home and noticed that no smoke was coming out of the chimney. Then Chief Investigator Bob Ball discovered there had been a power outage in the Keller's neighborhood Wednesday morning. And without power, the fan that would have ventilated the carbon monoxide emissions from the coal burner would not have been working. He says the house filled with CO at 8 times the normal fatal level, and the couple and their dog were quickly overcome.
That heater was still going, the heat inside there, but no fan. So nothing was circulating to get that out of there. So it just built up, and that's how we kind of figured this out. From the carbon monoxide cases I've worked in my years, they basically go to sleep. They don't really realize, you know, especially the more that the carbon's in their system, they just went to sleep.
Investigators say the case serves as a reminder that all homes should have CO detectors. Natalie, they also say if the home had a backup generator when the power shut down, that fan would have kept on working and they might still be alive.